Hi guys. In this tutorial, I will teach you how to make a composition and its settings. If you are interested in learning After Effects software, be sure to subscribe to my channel so that you can see the next tutorials. I click on the New Project option to create a new project. If you want to return to the Home section, click on the Home icon. Set the workspace to the default mode so that the layout of my panels and yours are the same. As I explained in the previous lesson, after creating a new project, we need to create a composition so that we can put the project files inside the composition. There are several ways to create a composition. We can select the New Composition option from the Composition menu, or press the Control button and N on the keyboard. Another method is to click on the New Composition option in the middle of the image. And the last method is to click on the Composition icon at the bottom of the project panel. You can use all these ways to create a new composition. In the Composition settings, we must first choose a name for it. In the Basic section, there is a preset option where we can choose different presets. Whatever preset we choose, all its settings will be applied to the composition. For example, if I select 4K preset 384.2160 with frame rate 25, you can see that the setting changes completely and does not need any other change. Or we can create a preview with a resolution of 1080x1080 for display on social media. The number at the end of each preset indicates the number of frames per second. Actually, in this preset, every 1 second consists of 30 frames. Or in this 4K preset, each second is 25 frames, which is referred to as frame rate. You will understand this better by doing projects in the future. I choose preset 1080 with a frame rate of 29.97. By choosing the custom option, we can create our own preset. By left-clicking and dragging, we can change the width and height settings and other settings. In normal mode, the width and height of the preset change in harmony. Disabling the aspect lock option allows us to change the width and height separately. The next option is the pixel aspect ratio. Pixels are usually square, resulting in a 1:1 pixel aspect ratio. But images that are optimized for certain types of displays can also have rectangular pixels with an aspect ratio of 4:3 or similar. Normally we use 16:9 square pixels. Here we can change the frame rate. I explained earlier that frame rate shows the number of frames in 1 second. Frames per second is a measurement technique that is equal to 29.97 frames per second. 2 frames are dropped every 2 minutes to give a total of 29.97 frames per second for streaming 30 FPS content. This option is activated only for frame rates 29.97 and 59.94. No need to change it. In the resolution section, we can determine the value of the video resolution in the composition panel. This determination of resolution is only related to playback in the After Effects environment and does not affect the final rendering. It depends on the power of your system whether the video plays well or not when running the project. I choose the half option. In the composition panel, we can change it again, which I will teach you later. At the start timecode box, we determine the start time of the composition. I don't change it so the composition starts at frame 0. The order of the numbers in After Effects is that the first number is the hour, the next number is the minute, the next number is the second, and the last number shows the number of frames. In the duration box, I determine the duration of the composition. Now it is on 30 seconds that we can change it. Here we determine the background color of the composition. Sometimes we need to change the color of the composition. With eyedropper, we can choose a color from the program itself or existing files. Any composition you set yourself can be saved using this option. I write a name for it. Now we can select it in the preset section. And we can easily remove that preset. Now I press the OK button to create a composition with the dimensions we determined. The composition icon is displayed in the project panel and the black background color is displayed in the composition panel. Now, this composition is ready to put different files inside it. For example, I double-click on the project panel and import a video. I drag the video and place it in the timeline. We can see this video from the composition panel. In future lessons, we will deal with the combination of different files in the composition. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Until the next tutorial, goodbye for now.